Hey, this is Hector with heart.kettlebell.com. Today I'm going to be sharing with you one of my other favorite assistance exercises. One of the other videos we talked about the deficit deadlift. Today we're going to be sharing with you the wedge. We're going to go over the wedge. This is another one of my favorite drills. So let's say I'm pulling Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, or Monday and Friday. It doesn't matter how many days a week that you're pulling. The days in between, as an assistance exercise, I like to work on my setup. And I like to really focus on my wedge. Well, what is the wedge? Well, think of like a wooden wedge that you would jam underneath the door, okay? The more you continue to jam that wedge underneath the door, what happens to the door? The door begins to rise and it begins to lift, right? Well, we're going to wedge ourselves between the floor and the ceiling with the bar. And as we wedge and put ourselves in the right position, if the weight is light enough, you will see the weights lift and they'll elevate. And essentially what you'll do is you'll remove, this is 100 kilos here. Essentially, when I wedge, I will remove 100 kilos off the bar. Because just by wedging, the weight lifted. And then from there, I get a leg drive and I go to my lockout. Okay? So, as I use this as an assistance exercise, I just focus on getting the weights to pop off the floor, and I keep my volume pretty low, 3, maybe 5, just depends on how heavy I pulled the day before. But this whole assistance exercise is all focused on your setup. Doesn't matter if this is sumo, doesn't matter if this is conventional. There's the wedge applies to both lifts. The goal of that wedge in this assistance exercise is to get the weights to pop up off the floor, and then you drop the weights and reset, and you do, I would recommend 3 to 5 repetitions. So one of our master kettlebell instructors, Fabio Zunin, says that your setup is your first rep, and I couldn't agree with him more. Your setup is your first rep, okay? So if our setup is off, we're not gonna pull right, or we're not going to press right, or we're not, whatever lift it is that we're trying to get better at, we're not gonna get better at because our setup is poor or it's off. It needs more work and more cleaning up. So I like to use as an assistance on days off that I'm not lifting, I use the wedge, okay? So you're gonna set up in whatever sumo or whatever conventional, whatever deadlift position you like to get yourself into, you're gonna get into that position. For sumo, make sure the shins stay vertical. Make sure that your shins are up against the bar, okay? Weights, you generally want to use weights that are in the 50% max. I mean, this should not be a big challenge as far as the weight, okay? So you want to keep the weights pretty light because the weights popping off the ground, that is your feedback that the wedge is working. So if you put too heavy of a weight on there and you wedge, the weights aren't going to go anywhere. What will happen in that situation is when you're actually pulling a heavy weight, like let's say you're going for a new rep max, when you wedge into the proper position, the weights won't pop off the floor, but the bar will bend into the position that it needs to go to, okay? So you wanna keep your hips high, and then as you get ready to wedge, you're gonna jam your hips in to get your hips closer to the bar. As you do that, if the weights are light enough, the weights will come off the floor. If you're actually pulling and the weights are heavy, like a rep max, you wedge, you keep your hips high, you jam your hips forward, the weights will stay on the floor, but the bar will bend into the position that it needs to, and then you'll lift the weight up off the ground, okay? So you set up in whatever position you normally would like, okay? This is about 40-ish percent of my max here, and I get into my grip position, okay? And then from here, I'm getting tight, and then I'm gonna jam my hips forward. And you saw the weights pop off the ground. I'll do this for 3 to 5 reps. And you saw how the weights slowly started to pop up off the ground. This is my favorite assistance exercise. Other than practicing like a hip mobility stretch with a deficit deadlift, practicing my setup is one of my favorite assistance exercises. This is definitely going to have more carryover into your deadlift, in my opinion, than doing any other types of exercises that don't have to do with a deadlift. So that's for another story. Kind of segmenting some body pieces. When you get to like a triple bodyweight deadlift and over, then yes, you'll have to add some of those additional exercises in. But if you're just learning how to deadlift and you're trying to get to a double body weighted deadlift or even a 2.5 times body weighted deadlift, in my opinion, I don't think you need to be getting lost in a sea of assistance exercises. Just practice the lift, get good at the lift, and you'll see your deadlift climb. Once you get to that 3 times body weighted deadlift, then you can start looking into adding more hamstring work, more upper back work, things like that. But Pavel Sotsalin, founder of Strong First, says, don't worry about assistance exercises, you have nothing to assist. And I was at a deadlift workshop when I heard him say this, and it slapped me right in the face, because I was like, man, what assistance exercises should I be doing? Because I was struggling with my deadlift at that time. Like, do I need to do assistance exercises? Which ones do I need to do? And I asked the question, and he said, don't worry about assistance exercises. You have nothing to assist. Just get strong at the deadlift. Practice the setup. Get good. Build a lot of volume with the deadlift by itself, and your deadlift will climb. To this day, I've never used any other assistance exercises other than the actual deadlift itself, practicing my wedge, and then the deficit deadlift hip stretch. And I was able to take my deadlift from 405 to 551 in about a year and a half. So practice your skills, practice this wedge. Like I said, keep your volume 3 to 5 repetitions, maybe 3 to 5 sets, and use that as your assistance exercise if you're new to the deadlift game. Okay, give this a try. Let us know how it goes. Leave a comment below or hit reply.